Hi. Welcome to our February Facebook Live.
Yes.
We're so excited. We have some big announcements to make, some that you might already know, but we want to say it again, and then we'll dive into your question. So, the unveiling, you ready? 1, 2, 3. Everyday Eyeshadow Palette, it's here.
Guys, the last time we were here, multiple of you asked, when is eyeshadow coming out? Some of you knew the next thing was eyeshadow. Well, it's here. The Everyday Eyeshadow Palette. You know what that? You see, we got the shades on the back for you girls. We got the shades listed in our little insert.
There's a whole insert.
A whole insert.
Probably not.
With the name. Should we read the names? Oh, yeah.
We should.
We should. Actually, let's give you a visual while we read them. Okay. So, starting with beige. Light bright, first date,
such a perfect name,
tandemonium, upside brown, second date,
wow, with something,
red bone, queen sugar, and of course, brown out.
Can't deepest brown you need.
I mean, let's just give the girls.
And the mirror, can we, with this big, large mirror, you can do your whole face.
Your whole face.
You're welcome.
So, I mean, we could not be more excited. This has been such a labor of love. Like, we have been in the lab, girls, giving you fully pigmented everyday shades. Because the thing is, and a lot of y'all have said this, there's so many new palettes out there that you buy and you can only wear two shades because the rest don't show up on our skin. It's like dust. It's like ash. It's nothing. Not with these girls. Okay, right. Just so you know.
There are so many shades, so many colors, but all very subtle and beautiful, from the very light to the dramatic. So you can do your day look. You can transition into evening. You can go on full glam if you want. I mean, it's for every day, all day. Yes. Like, so excited about it. Pre-orders went live on the 9th. So I know many of you have already copped it, but pre-orders are still live. You should really get it while you can, because like, we went live on the 9th and it's exploded. Mm-hmm. So people are buying them, and I would go ahead and secure mine if I were you. And don't you just love the pop of purple inside the box?
Yeah, for sure. And the other thing is, we should say what shades we're wearing. So I think I have on 3 shades. On my lid, I have on second date, which is our bronze shimmer. As my transition shade, I have red bone, which is our like red brown blend, like kind of my favorite shade in the palette. And then sort of all over, I sweeped a little bit of Queen Sugar, which is our gorgeous purple shade, and just to give it a little bit more depth.
Mm-hmm.
What about you?
So I have on Tandemonium as my base, which is a nice medium brown, has a little kind of orangey in it, so it's not a flat brown. It's really nice. Then a little red bone in my crease, giving me some depth. And then a little beige just up here on the eyebrow, and a little bit here in my inner corner. So, hooray. Different looks for different folks for different times today.
Yeah.
So excited.
Yeah.
Hi, Lithonia. Thanks for joining us. Doing a happy dance. I literally got a text. My Minted lipstick and gloss will be delivered today. It's only my 4th order.
Yes.
Thank you.
Amen. We appreciate that.
Yes.
Oh, and you didn't say, but you have some second date on your
Oh, yes. And I'm highlighting with second date because it is a very versatile palette.
Okay. Ooh, let me tell you what else I like to do with the palette since we're talking about it. So if you girls are looking for a nice contour shade here, upside brown, this shade here, I will contour with. And let me tell you, when I do contour with it, I use a tiny bit, okay, because we're giving you the pigments. So you don't need a lot. This is a great shade for contouring for my skin tone. And actually, we just watched one of our favorite influencers, who's a bit deeper than both of us, use brown out as a contour. And that, I mean, that is a deep shade. So if you are very deep toned, we're giving you value, okay? We're giving you shadows. We're giving you contours. We're giving you highlights. And don't be fooled, there's also some blush in here. Because what I like to do is mix red bone and queen sugar. Again, you don't need a lot. It's much more pigmented than your average blush.
Mm-hmm.
Dip a real light, and then, you know,
give yourself a little pop on the cheek, too.
Bit of blush. We're giving you value, okay? That's the moral of the story.
That's the moral of the story. The palette is $28. Go to mentedcosmetics.com and get it today. I would highly recommend that because they're going quickly.
They are.
So let's jump. Unless you want to shout out your husband.
Oh, hey. Hey, boo. My husband is Kadar Miller. So
he joined.
Yeah, we're happy to see you that you joined here.
Also, hi, Sharon Johnson. Good morning. I'm in Los Angeles, Minted Moguls. Thanks for your chat. Well, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for joining us. We have lots of questions.
Yes, let's jump in. So from Instagram, Little Sean Trace says, what's the shelf life on your lip gloss? Do you want to take that?
Sure. So the shelf life on our gloss and our lipstick is 2 years. So barring, you know, you wasting any toxic chemicals on it, it should last for 2 years. So, you know, that's value.
That's a good deal. As you would say.
$16.50 and that lipstick lasts for 2 years.
Well, your lipstick don't last for
Well, no, I go through a tube a month, okay? But, you know, the average person.
Right.
Okay, so also from Instagram, Sabrinza asks two questions. Will you create a blush palette and a soft pink lip gloss? So, Sabrinza, blush is definitely in our sights. Now, don't forget, you can get a little bit of blush out of this here eyeshadow palette. But, yes, blush is in our sights. Amanda is a blush girl.
I'm so excited.
And through, okay? So, we're definitely going to be doing blush. Yeah. And we might have some, you know, lip gloss things in the works.
Glossy surprises.
We might.
We hear you, girls, is the point. We see it. We hear you.
We're always listening.
Dorf fan from Instagram, please, please, please make the announcement that you will start shipping to Canada. Oh, Dorf fan, I'm sorry. We're not making that announcement today, but we are working on it. That's what's important. So
we are working on it. 100%. We are working on it. And we heard a little rumor, maybe the Canadians can chime in here. We heard a little rumor that you guys are used to paying more in shipping because so much of what you're buying is coming from the States. But I will say what we are really trying to commit to is not giving you high shipping costs to get our product. We don't want people to spend $16 on a lipstick and $16 to ship the lipstick. Like, we personally think that's crazy, even though apparently there are Canadians more than willing to do it. So that's really what we're working on. Like, when we do it, we don't want to be, you know, crazy with the shipping costs. So that's what we're working on, but we promise we are working on it.
So let us know. We'd love to hear from you on what you guys think about shipping.
So Carmella 2002 says, any plans on a line of foundation? Well, well, well. Yeah, we think about foundation a lot, and for sure it is on our product development roadmap. We can't tell you when, we can't tell you how, we can't tell you anything really, other than
that's a lot of information. That's more than anybody else has.
Yeah,
you heard it here first. We're thinking about it. YTM Hugh,
sure,
from Instagram says, when can you do a pop-up in Houston? Mm. What a great question, because so timely. We were just talking about our 2018 pop-up schedule, all the cities we're going to hit, East Coast, West Coast, down South, Midwest. Yes. We're so excited to get out there and meet you all and talk about product and play with product. Houston, we're thinking about you. Once again, we're not going to confirm or deny or say when, but to this and a lot of questions, I would say actually join our email list. Yeah. Those are the people who know first. So if we are, say, going to go to Houston, we would absolutely email the people in Texas. So if you are on our email list, you will know first. But we are thinking about that big state.
Yeah, we surely are. Okay, Sharon D. Johnson has a lot of questions. We're going to answer them, girl.
Oh, and you're live.
Hey, girl. Okay, how and when did you find the chemist / lab to work with you on your formulas? Great question. So it was a process for sure. And in the beginning, actually, Amanda and I handmade all of our lipsticks and our glosses because we wanted those shades to be perfect. And we found that unless we created the perfect shades, we couldn't really trust a lab to create them for us. So in the beginning, Amanda and I were literally sitting in our kitchens making these shades by hand. But once we perfected them, that's when we went and we sort of did a roadshow to find the best lab. We called a bunch of different ones. We met with a bunch of different ones and eventually settled down on a lab that was willing to work with us and really understood what we were trying to do in terms of like the nuanced shades we were trying to create. But it took a lot of trial and error. It took a lot of meeting with people. And I would say, no matter what it is you're trying to create, you never want to just go with the first person whose name you see, like Bob Manufacturer. You know, you want to call around. And now when we're introducing, working on new products, we're big on references and recommendations. Right. Who have you worked with in the industry? Who can vouch for you? Because, you know, there are a lot of shady folks out there, and we're not trying to get caught up in all that.
True.
Another
question from Sharon D. Johnson. How much startup capital did you need?
$1 billion.
I was going to say, we'll have to go into specific numbers, right, but I think like what we were very thoughtful about the company we wanted to build, how we wanted to grow, what products we wanted to release, when, how we wanted to market to you guys. We put all that in a forecast and said, okay, this is how much we think we'll need to start up. But so what KJ was saying earlier, when we really just started in our apartments as our lab, building out things, we paid for all of that ourselves. So it's been a journey, and capital has shifted and come from a lot of different places. But if you're thinking of starting a startup, you'll see that evolution of capital shift and move. But a great place to start is with yourself and what you have.
Yeah, agreed. And also from Sharon, how difficult was it to get money commitment from investors or business loans from banks? That is also a great question. I will say it was very difficult in the beginning. It's a lot less difficult these days, now that we have a proven track record. But in the beginning, when it was just two girls with a dream and, you know, a closet full of lipstick, we had to take people on that journey. And I think one thing that will happen if any of you are looking into entrepreneurship is you do become a really good storyteller, because you are telling your story and pitching your story all the time. It's not just in meetings with investors. It's every time you connect with anyone, because you never know whose uncle, father, best friend, husband is an investor. And sometimes, and we had this happen to us plenty of times, you know, we'd be out at a networking event, we'd be having drinks, and we would talk about Mented and say, you know, it's upscale beauty for women of color. Women of color outspend their white counterparts on beauty, but so often we're neglected when we walk into the store. And just that one sentence would have someone say, you know what, you should talk to so-and-so at such-and-such fund, or you should talk to my such-and-such friend who's an angel investor, whatever. So you're sort of always pitching. And while it was very difficult in the beginning, we honed our skills and got good at giving the pitch and sort of pitching everywhere. Yeah. I think we're better at it now. And also now that there's sort of proof, the proof is in the pudding, now that we have a track record, it's not as difficult as it used to be.
Yeah. Hi, Yolanda Wallace.
Hello.
I'm so excited. I've already placed my pre-order. You guys have the best colors. I have all the lipsticks and the gloss. Can you say addicted? Also wanted to say, I ordered some shades for my auntie who was going through chemotherapy, and she said your colors are the only ones that always compliment her changing skin tone due to the therapy. You ladies rock. Keep it up.
That's amazing.
Oh, Yolanda, that is so nice. Thanks for sharing that.
And shout to your auntie. Please give her our love, Yolanda, because that's amazing to hear. And you know what? I just feel like the idea that our shades are complementing melanated women's skin tone in their various stages of skin tones is just everything we dreamed when we started this brand. So shouts to you and shouts to your auntie.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll jump back in. Facebook question. Princess Collins Williams says, I love your lip gloss collection. Will you guys produce a Mented matte collection near future? Thanks in advance.
Okay.
First off, can I just say, I love the product ideas that come from you guys. Yes. It's always so interesting to see what you want next. What are you interested in? Where are the gaps? So we appreciate it. Keep it coming. We have thought about matte. So as you know, our lipsticks right now are semi-matte. And then of course we have gloss. We are thinking about what future combinations and states make sense. It is on our radar to keep thinking about it. And so the more we hear from you guys, like, what do you want? What's next? What do you need? It's helpful in helping us think about, like, what's actually next. So I'll say to this, Princess, keep it coming.
Yes. Okay, next question from Facebook, Amanda Rogers. Hello. My question is, why are your products so pricey?
Okay, Amanda, what the shit? Okay, girl, thanks for putting that one in there.
Oh, well. Amanda, appreciate the question. Here's the thing. We actually thought long and hard about what our price points could and should be. And we actually feel really good in saying this, that we think they're very affordable for the quality. And that is something that was incredibly important to us. You know, when we think about the brands that we consider ourselves in league with, a $16 lipstick is right in line and, in fact, below the average price for a lot of the other brands that we do consider ourselves in league with. So we are very conscious about building an affordable prestige brand. It's not going to be drugstore pricing because you are getting higher than drugstore quality. Every single product is vegan, non-toxic, paraben-free, cruelty-free, and made in the United States. Okay, so we can't make that commitment to you and sell you a $7 lipstick. That said, I'm telling you, the quality is there. And we are trying to make sure that, oops, I'm sorry, shook the table. We're giving you quality at an affordable price. So appreciate the question and, you know, get on the email list for the discount codes, girl.
Right. And shout out from Sharon D, who says, I think your price point is great. Appreciate it, girl.
Appreciate that. Yes, yes.
From Facebook, Sue Denim says, are there any plans to sell small sample sizes / swatches of the lipsticks or lip glosses? I want to try the different shades myself, but also thought it might be a nice gift. Although all of your shades look really appealing. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Sue.
Yeah.
So we get this a lot. We hear this. People want to know, can they buy samples? Can they buy small sizes? We hear you. We're working on it. Mm-hmm. We're thinking about it.
That's Amanda's favorite answer.
We're thinking about it. I like, this is the first time I heard though about it, is really as a nice gift.
So, it would be a nice gift.
Yeah. To be like, oh, let me share Mented with you. I don't know what you like, but here's a little kind of sample of all of them.
Yeah.
Great idea.
That is a really great idea. Oh. And I will just say about the sample sizing, I think what a lot of people don't realize is that it actually costs almost the exact same amount of money to make a mini size of a product as a big size. Now, I'm not talking about the sample, the paper, like you lift it up and there's like one little swipe of lipstick, but I'm talking about if you actually make a mini tube of lipstick, which is, I think, the way we'd want to do it. I hate those little sample packets of one swipe of lipstick, like we'll do with lipstick on one corner. So I think if we do it, it would be in a mini tube, and that resource-wise is the same. So it's just an investment for us, but it's not an investment we're unwilling to make. It's just one we have to think about in terms of timing. Yeah. So,
and what I would say would actually be a really nice gift, if you don't know maybe what to get your friend, is to use our build a trio function on our website. So go on there, pick your favorite three shades, send it to your friend, and I think she'll find something she loves.
Yes.
So it's a good one.
And it's good value.
It is good value.
Okay, Joy Greason says, I have no clue how to put on eyeshadow or foundation. I don't know how to match it to my skin color. What do you suggest? Well, Joy, I can talk to you about eyeshadow and just say, one, I love watching YouTube and watching all the looks that the YouTube girls put together. And two, we have some videos coming out very soon that will show you exactly how to use this gorgeous palette. So stay tuned. I mean, very soon.
Yeah.
Like, you will start seeing these videos come out. So we're here for you. We will teach you. And the great thing about this palette is the reason we called it an everyday eyeshadow palette is because you don't have to know how to do anything fancy to make it work. You can literally throw some Tandemonium on your lid and maybe put a little bit of Red Bone in your crease or a little bit of Queen Sugar or, you know, just to give it a little bit of depth. Two shades, you're done. It's already going to bring your look up. You're already going to look so great and, you know, just give you a little bit of oomph. And, you know, it's two shades and it's easing out. And every single shade was made for, you know, us brown girls. So I just think this, if you're not sure how to use eyeshadow, you buy this palette because right. You don't need to be an expert to use it.
Exactly. More to come. Shout out to people. Diamante Sims. Oh, my God. I'm so glad I didn't miss this. Love you both. Aw.
Well, thank you.
We love you, too. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah. Thank you for being here.
Okay. Next question. Okay, IG, y'all sandals. Husky alum 2011 says, so beautiful, smart, and innovative. Oh, appreciate the compliment.
That's nice. Sabrinza says, will you do a pop-up in New York City? Good question, and the answer is yes. We can definitively say we will do another pop-up here in the city because it's, you know, our heart and soul is this city, and we love meeting you guys in person. So we are doing another one. We can't yet announce when, but for sure, if you're on the email list or you're following us on the gram, you will hear about it.
Facts. Sabrinza also asked, lip liners to match lipsticks and lip gloss? Question mark. We know you girls love it. We know you love a good lip liner. I will say, we've always said this from the beginning, our lipsticks and lip glosses don't need a lip liner, but we hear you that a lot of you love using lip liner and like you want to. So again, throw it on the list of things we're working on. We hear you. Keep, you know, letting us know. The more you guys bubble up things, then, you know, the more we know it's something our customers really, really want. So yeah, thanks for letting us know.
And same for the lip scrubs, which was your other question, Sabrina. Definitely, we're thinking about it for sure. Pastels in Space asks, will y'all be releasing any lip liners or foundation in the future? I want to have clean makeup in my bag, but it's hard to find, especially for melanated ladies. Yes, and I think we addressed this a little earlier too. We absolutely have foundation in our sights. We have lip liners in our sights. So, you know, stay tuned and join the email list because our goal is to give you a full face of Mented. So trust me when I say it's all in the works.
Yeah.
It's just about timing.
Timothy Mayfield says, yes, still put my bid in for a red Mented line and also going to need you guys to come out with a Mented highlight line. Have so much trouble picking a highlight, hoping my choice will actually go with my skin. Well, Timothy, I will say this, not quite a comment on the red Mented line yet, but a comment on the highlight. Introducing the Everyday Eyeshadow.
Girl, when I say we're giving you value, we're giving you value.
Beautiful metallic shades in there. First Date, which is like a gold shimmer, and Second Date, which is a bronze shimmer. I'm wearing Second Date as a highlighter right now. You have Second Date on your eyelids, mm-hmm. right? Which is, yeah, so you can see shimmer. So we actually already have you on the highlight right now. So there's a way you can get a clean Mented highlight.
Yeah.
And of course we'll think about expanding it and all those things in the future. But right now we actually can service your needs. So
we're giving you value. I just don't know if everyone who's here now was here in the beginning. So just kind of just highlight again.
Something about value.
The value in this. Well, I'm going to do it again. Okay. I just want y'all to know that not only are we giving you 9 gorgeous eyeshadow shades, okay, but you can, I've done it before, mix together Red Bone and Queen Sugar and create a great blush. I have used both of these shimmers as highlight, okay? I have used Upside Brown in the center here as a contour, okay? So we are giving, along with the shadow. I just feel like, for $28, is anyone else giving you as much
they
value?
They are not. That is fact. They are not.
Oh, okay. Last question we have here on the list is from Adrian Raquel. Are your shadows vegan? Yes, girl.
Yes.
Yes, vegan all day.
Well, thanks for you guys' questions.
Yeah, we appreciate
that
it.
That was really
helpful. Feel free to type any other questions that you may have.
Well, I have a question for you.
Okay.
So you are going to LA this weekend, City of Glam. Do you have any looks in mind that you are excited to create with the eyeshadow palette? Like, you're about to be out in Hollywood with the celebs. What you gonna do?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go full drama every day. I'm gonna go full lash. I'm gonna go full smoke. I'm gonna use 6 shades at a time from the palette. Because why not? It's LA, and I never go to LA. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go full glam for the whole trip.
If you were to do a deep smoky look, what shades would you use?
Well, let's talk about it. I use the insert this time. I don't know if you guys can see it. I think if I were going to do full on smoky, I'd keep the Second Date, which is our bronze shimmer, as my lid shade. But then along with Redbone and Queen Sugar in my crease and transition area, I would take Upside Brown, which is our one of our deep browns, and really smoke out the corner here. Like, really pack it in to give me that smoke. That'd be step one. And then I think if I wanted to do a matte smoky look, I would just use Upside Brown all over my lid and take brown out, which is like just one step lighter than black, and do that all in my crease and outer corner here.
We'll
probably bring it down underneath my eyes. I mean, really give them the drama.
Well, we were actually just talking about this before the live of thinking through eyeshadow on the lower lid here, or on the waterline. Like,
yeah.
Thoughts, colors you want to try?
I currently have on Redbone and Queen Sugar on my waterline, lash line. I like it. I don't know if I'm doing it right. You know, this is one of those things like when our makeup artist comes and does it, it looks amazing. I'm like, ooh, I should do this every day. And then when I do it, I'm like, I don't feel right. But, you know, I'm learning.
Yeah. Sharon, where in LA? Would love to meet you if it's a public event.
Aw, thank you. I'd love to meet you too. It's actually just meeting up with some college friends. I never go to LA, and they've been asking for a long time for me and my husband to come visit. And so we finally said we would. So it's not a public event. I'm going to be eating tacos and wearing lashes the whole time. That's it.
So you're going to lash daytime, nighttime cocktails, breakfast.
Yes, but we do have LA in our sights for pop-up time. So yes. Sharon, mark counts. Okay. But yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm just so excited to talk to people about the palette. Like, what are you going to do? What do you think about this? Are you going to try this?
I know. I cannot wait. I'm so, so excited. I guess I have a question for you.
Okay.
Now, you always talk about the fact that you have hooded eyes.
And it is my burden to bear.
So, how do you feel like you are not overcoming, because I don't think it's a disability, but how do you think about shadow now that you're clearly going to be wearing it more often?
Right.
With your hooded eyes.
Mm-hmm. Good question. So I've watched a bunch of YouTube videos to help me with this because I just have less surface area. I'm not disabled. So I've had to find my new language and come over my issues. Mm-hmm. But basically everyone just says, bring it up. So if you have hooded eyes like me where you can't really see how KJ has all that good surface area where you can see what's on the lid. I don't have that. So if I'm going to wear something, I need to bring the color up way further up than you think. So if I do a metallic on my lid, one of the shimmers, I just need to bring it up that much more so that you can actually see it when my eyes are open. Mm-hmm. What else? Also, the kind of crease color. So more than you think you might need. So if I do red bone or I do queen sugar and my crease, I just need to take it that much closer to my eyebrows than I think that I need to take it and put on that much more so you can actually kind of see it and it pops. So hooded eye girls can do eyeshadow. We just have to work at it a little more, a little more to overcome. We get there. Let me not make this sound like this is the trouble of my life. I am okay with my hooded eyes. And I love that they're so many different types of colors in the palette that I can use because I have hooded eyes. So there are things that you just kind of can't see on me normally, but with this palette you can because everything is super pigmented so you can actually see it. I can go from day to night. I don't have to glam all day with glitter. I can have a great matte look that actually shows up and there are enough transition colors. I think the other thing with hooded eyes is using a lot of deep colors, really dark blacks and stuff, just make you look like you've been punched in the eye because you don't have enough surface area to kind of see the color contrast. These colors are soft and beautiful and muted, and so I never look punched in the eye, which I'm just going to consider a blessing.
Awesome. Well, great. I feel good about that.
Yeah. Anything else for the peeps? People, do you have any other questions for us? Also, if you are from L.A., Houston, other places, rip your city, let us know where you're from so we can make sure we get there.
Yeah, definitely. And this has been super fun as always. Girls, we're giving you the value with the palette, so you gotta get the palette.
Yeah.
I don't know what else to say. You gotta get the palette.
So you're telling them they should get the palette.
You really should get the palette.
It's something about a value.
There's so much value in the palette. Yeah.
All right, ladies, till next time.
Bye.